Hey everybody, how's it?
Aloha.
Okay, Throwback Thursdays, Oingo Boingo Nasty Habits. But wait a second, stand by now. You know, who would have thought that from this album, a groundbreaking album in 1981 with such unique composition led by major composer Danny Elfman of so many TV shows and films and video games, who would have thought from this would yield such amazing talent? There was a hint. There was already a hint of what he was going to become, and that's because I chose this particular song because I guarantee you, you're going to be able to identify at least two, maybe three, maybe even four either TV shows or films that Danny Elfman has scored with a very similar technique that he used in Oingo Boingo. And to me, as being a composer, I don't idol anybody. But if I'm in total awe of many composers like John Williams, and there are quite a few other ones, but Danny Elfman's depth and dynamics and his range and his composition palette and what he can pull off in so many different types of films is amazing. But to me, I always remember him as this big, smiley, entertainment, animated, incredibly talented songwriter that turned into a masterful choreographer. Oh my God, am I drooling? Because that guy is just amazing. And I get to celebrate it here on my Throwback Thursday. I only stopped one time in this because I want us to enjoy this together, but I will bring out some really cool things and then we'll wrap it up at the end. But ladies and gentlemen, for your entertainment value on Throwback Thursday, I bring to you Oingo Boingo Nasty Habits. All right. In my soundtrack of life and where I was, you know, just breaking into, you know, getting into my, I was in my late teens at this point. So I was getting in all kinds of trouble and having fun and stuff. And this was, you know, when this first came out, it absolutely standout breakout production, composition, and everything. But the unique performance, and it's all, you know, it's all like, it's all like about timing. Just when Danny and his band wrote, well, Danny wrote and the band performed and put together Oingo Boingo came at a perfect time. This kind of, there was a punk era that was kind of there was a twisting in the wind, if you would, of a punk era, and then the videos started showing up, MTV and the whole thing, and this came out and caught all of us like off guard in my little hui, in my little club of guys and surfers and stuff like that. As a composer, to break this down, there are so many intricate layers here. There's so many counter melodies that are going on. Definitely not shy of doing multiple arrangements, the layers I was telling you about. You've got horns that are hitting really percussive staccato little riffs and phrases. The piano is very... What movies? Okay, just stand by for a second. At the end of this, type in what movies. Because I can guarantee you, I can say this ended up being something like this in this movie, and in this movie, and in this movie, and in this movie, and in this movie. I think something else that was really intriguing for me at the day, and then even now when I listen to it, his performance is amazing. His performance, he is in it. He is vested in this song, and as I recall, he's completely vested in this whole album as a performer. Very unique way of expressing himself and over-exaggerating a lot of his enunciation and stuff like that. He was already a master of performance at the release of this album here. And then the unique, what we just heard, the multiple layers of the voices in the 16th. It's just Danny Elfman. Anyhow, let's go back. We're going to listen to it. We're going to finish it up, talk a little more. And then I might lay on a hint to you on which films you think I might think that you think that I think that he may have done that you know that I think that I've done. Ready? And here we go.
I wonder. People are so proper when they're going about their business. Cup of coffee, friendly conversation till they get home. Till they get home. Take the phone off, lock the door, and shut the curtains. Make sure that the neighbors are without suspicion. No one will know. No one will know. Nasty habits.
I'm sorry, you can see it just brought me back to everything to when I was in my late teens that I could remember. And, you know, some really, truly unique in this time again, you know, you really didn't hear a lot of horns in this kind of genre. I don't even know if we can pocket this in a particular genre. It wasn't pop music and it wasn't, you know, contemporary or anything. It was Danny Elfman. It was Oingo Boingo. And I would have loved to have been a fly on the room whenever whoever the A&R person was on the first deal or whoever it was that they sat down and if they probably just said, let's just give Danny the reins, let's let him do what he's got to do, because there was nothing that was that was before this that you can automatically say, oh, well, he was influenced by, at least in my, you know, that's where you and your comments and anybody who's more familiar with that, maybe there's other things in the past that bands sounded like that that I'm not familiar with that maybe he could have drawn influence from. The engineering here is absolutely insane. So much separation is going on. And even though there's a main piano that's doing that, there's other keyboards that do things. In the second passage, you may have seen me kind of go, that's because there was a small keyboard riff that was being played not quite often that started off over here, one riff, then in the middle riff, and then it was panned to this side. All of the trumpet, all the horn stabs and everything like that were in a perfect stereo. The performance of the horns was as pristine and as marvelous as it can be. There was different guitar sounds that were being used at times. There was during the slide solo. Excuse me. There was a lot going on. I would have loved to have seen the tape on the console back in the old days. If that was 1981, there was no digital consoles yet. I don't think Trident Diane even came out yet. So everything is here, and you can group stuff, but there used to be a big tape that you would lay all the way across above the faders, and you would write your notes and stuff like that. And, you know, at times, if you didn't have automation, what did have automation back in 81? I don't recall. But I would have loved to have seen the destination of the pan pots and stuff like that, because there's some incredibly wonderful separation in the engineering that truly I'd have to go back and listen to. Anyhow, listen, I gush only because this was a definite song in the soundtrack of my life that I wanted to just bring and circle around to you guys. Not only because I thought it was fun, great for Throwback Thursday, but because of the fact that this was in the pop world, the embryonic beginning of Danny Elfman being presented to the world as a musician, composer, arranger, and the trajectory he went on. And look what he's done now. I'm going to put the link to his IMDb page down there, and so you could check what films that he's done. But if you already have a feeling of what it was that he's done, or you can sense it, type it in the comments. You know, I'd like to hear what you guys pull from this. Anyhow, this is my ya-ya thing. Throwback Thursdays is my ya-ya thing. It doesn't fit any genre, anything that I'm doing here, except it's for me. It's my ya-ya. So anyhow, thanks for hanging out. I'm going back to some pretty heavy prog this weekend and next week. So be warned. All right. Stupid.